Now, it's no secret, the Y chromosome is so much smaller than the X chromosome. And there is an amazingly cool story behind all of this. Please go read about it. It's amazing. It's been going on for a long time. The Y chromosome has been getting smaller and smaller for the last, 100 million years or so. But the result has had dramatic implications for genes that are expressed from the X chromosome and that don't exist on the Y chromosome. Think about it for a second. Let's say we're interested in this gene that causes red-green color blindness, and it's on the X chromosome. Well, females have two X chromosomes, so anytime we're looking at their inheritance patterns, it's pretty much the same thing and straightforward as we've ever looked at for the autosomes, because females have two copies, they have two alleles, they can be homozygous, they can be heterozygous, they can be plus plus, plus minus, or minus minus. And for recessive traits, when they're homozygous recessive, then they're going to show the trait, let's say for red-green color blindness. But for the sake of it, let's say that the female is heterozygous, dominant and recessive. So they're not actually red-green colorblind, but they carry an allele for it. Males don't have that luxury. It's almost like the females have a backup copy, functioning copy of the gene, so they aren't red-green colorblind. But males, sure, they have one X chromosome. The Y chromosome is missing the piece of information that would correlate to the same region on the X chromosome. They don't have this gene. So if the male has the dominant copy, great, he's gonna see color vision just fine. But if he inherits even just one allele, one recessive allele for red-green color blindness, that's all it takes. He doesn't have anything to counteract the effect, and so he's gonna be red-green color blind. So in our pedigree up at the top here, we have an affected great-grandfather. And if he is XY, we know that he has an affected allele. If he has any daughter, he must pass that allele on because both daughters are XX. They get one X from mom and one X from dad. And the X that came from dad had to have been the one with the recessive allele. So both of these daughters are carriers. They have to be because we know they're unaffected. See, they're not shaded. That means they're not red-green colorblind. They must have gotten the recessive allele from their father. And then if we look at this individual's children here, these two, she had an unaffected daughter. We have no idea if she passed on the recessive allele or not because it's masked. But in the case of her son, we see very clearly he must have the recessive allele because he's affected. So although the trait looks like it skipped a generation, right? It looks like it went from grandfather to grandson. The allele didn't skip anybody. The allele went right from grandfather to mother to son. You can see it. You can track it in the pedigree. So the lesson from all of this is that although phenotypes appear to skip generations sometimes, the alleles never skip. And in the case of sex-linked traits, when they're linked to either the X or the Y chromosome, because there are some traits linked only to the Y chromosome, the patterns can be a little bit more tricky to discern because the males don't have another copy to complement their X chromosome.